general, draw lines in the sand. We're not going to do this. As a matter of fact, I'll give you a better one. Let's make it a little bit more to the demo in the hands. You know how many people in this room 10 years ago said, I'm never getting a cell phone. Why would I want anybody to get a hold of me anytime they want? A lot of you just don't want to admit it. Things change, and they're changing very quickly. And if you plan on being in business, and you don't recognize that things like Facebook and Twitter and Ustream and Tumblr and Daily Booth and all these sites matter so much to your business, you're out of your mind. Because, my friends, I've lived in this business my whole life, and I've heard so many times from so many people complaining about the press or distributors or retailers. Lots. Whether it's screw this guy or I hate this, or you're selling it too low, or I didn't get a 90, this is bullshit, or whatever it is. The fact of the matter is, because of this platform, which by the way, the internet, the consumer internet that we all know, is 15 years old. It's a baby. The internet hasn't had sex yet. And for us to debate that this platform is not revolutionizing our world is silliness. And I know there's a lot of people representing a lot of different countries here. And I'm in the internet space and I live it. I don't want to hear the excuse that America's so much further ahead and my country's not there yet, because nothing for nothing, stop crying. That's the biggest opportunity you have, because it's coming to your country too. And this is moving very quickly, and things are changing very quickly. And what it comes down to is one thing, my friends, one thing. You now have, for the first time, a true ability to connect directly to the consumer. No buffer, no gatekeeper, nobody has the key anymore. In the media business, no more editor at the New York Times telling you that you're good enough to write. In LA, no producer saying that you're pretty enough, or skinny enough, or charismatic enough to be on television. And in the wine business, no 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 critics telling the consumer what they should drink or how they should drink it. You have the responsibility, whether you are a winery, an importer, a retailer, in the trade, content, personality. I mean, Kevin, what he's been doing on Twitter has been phenomenal for me to watch. The man has been educating for, I don't want to hear about age, Kevin, you're not that old, but I'm saying, I mean, he's not 25 either, and you know what he's doing in there? He's engaging. People are asking questions, he's answering them. He's doing it textbook perfect. Do you know why he's doing it? I'm going to tell you why right now, without even really knowing him all that well, except sending my entire staff to his classes for years. Because Kevin gives a shit. See, the problem here is this. We have long been lying about how much we care about the consumer. We've been lazy. We've let other people do it for us. So many people in this room and in our industry have allowed other people to tell their story. You've let other people tell your story, whether it's a wine critic, a retailer, a distributor, a newspaper, a magazine, a radio station. You have fundamentally allowed everybody to tell your story to the consumer, everybody but you. For you to say, well, when am I going to do my real job instead of being on Twitter or Facebook or answering email is insanity. I answer 1,000 emails a day. I've been in my hotel room up to just now answering emails. You know why? Because I care. People think that Wine Library TV was successful because it was video. There's been 4,000 video wine shows that have come out since Wine Library TV. They didn't win, not because I'm crazy and I have toys on my table and I taste wine, because I promise you, far majority in this room don't like that, and plenty of other people don't like that. It's not that. And it's not because I'm the most educated, because I promise you, if you ever hear me pronounce any of these things, I'm not the most educated. But here's what I know. I'm passionate and I care. Because every time somebody emailed me when they watched the show and said, you're a jerk off, I wrote back and said, I'm not. Let's taste some wine. You'll see I'm a good guy. Or, you're great. Thank you. Or, what's this? I get emailed 50 times a day. What wine should I have with chicken? And I answer it. Every day. And I answer it, and not control copy and paste, and not a standard thing, and not my assistant, me. Because what has been missing, not only in the wine business, but in business forever, is customer service and caring. What these technologies are gonna do, all these things you think are silly, the iPhones and Twitter and all this crap, it's bringing it back to the the way your grandparents built your business, by actually caring about the consumer, going door to door, and caring, and tasting, and meeting people, the way Robert Mondavi, with all due respect to a lot of legends in Napa, put that brand on his shoulders and worked for 30 years going everywhere and built that brand, that's what you can do for your brand and your business. To rely on the press to say that 09 California is not going to be good because it rained, or that 02 wasn't a good year in Europe, that is storytelling, and it hurts your business. And you have the absolute ability to combat that by telling your own story, by having a little bit of marketing savvy, storytelling, like Charlie Wheeler over there. Storytelling, that's why he sells companies for lots of money, because he goes to the consumer and he cares and he works his ass off. And so what's fascinating to me, what's really interesting to me, just enormously exciting, is that every person in this room, regardless of your financial situation, whether you're a startup and you make 500 cases of an Albarino, or you're a monster and you make tons of wine, you got tons of cash and investment and all that, this new platform, the internet, the thing we're talking about, has fundamentally leveled the playing field. The fact that you look at my stats for Wine Library TV, and if you want to put me in the wine critics category or whatever, wine education, wine content, and you look at the girth, when you look at 850,000 people follow me on Twitter, that 100,000 people a day watch my show, when you think about that, and you think about that it's not even 4 years old, and it didn't cost me anything to make, you've got to start looking at this at a business way. I'm not here for the romance. You think I give a crap about Facebook or Twitter? I don't. I care about the message. I care about customers. I promise you, if customers still looked in the air for smoke signals, I'd be on the top of this building right now. I don't care how they get it. I don't care about that. I care about getting it to them. And you should be embarrassed as a business person if you don't recognize the cost on return investment that this platform allows you to do. You should be downright embarrassed, and you are grossly negligent if you are not putting your company at the forefront of this technology, because it is game-changing. It is everything that every person in this industry bitched about for the last 3 decades, that a couple people control the game. This is the absolute democratization of wine, the platform, and by the way, everything. I mean, trust me, I'm giving this same talk in 3 days in LA about media. It's the same game, my friends. We can talk to the consumer. That is crazy. Do you know how much money you would have had to spend to talk to this many people? Do you know how much time it would have taken you to fly around the whole world and do wine tastings with all these people? Do you know how many letters you would have had to read and write back to actually care about people? This is game-changing, society-changing. We disrespect culture shifts. People used to throw trash out the window when they drove on the highway. People used to smoke cigarettes in airplanes. People used to do a lot of things. People used to wear suit and ties to athletic events in the 40s and 50s. Things change. And what's changing right now is one thing. Not the internet, not Facebook. Business. This is business.